Hi, I'm Deanna Ciccone, and welcome to Viva News. Today, I'll be joined by naturopath Dr. Joyce Johnson. We'll be discussing stress, how to cope, as well as how it impacts your immune system during cold and flu season. Let's talk about sleep. I mean, life is so crazy these days. There's work, you've got the kids, a million things going on, and it's so hard at the end of the day. All you want to do, I know me personally, is get a good night's sleep, yeah. But I've got a million things going on in my head. And then that leads to restless nights. Yes. You know, let's talk about that. Am I alone or what?
No, 30% of Canadians have trouble falling asleep, staying asleep, getting a good night's sleep. We sleep an hour less than we did 25 years ago. So sleep deprivation is across the nation.
So then what can you do? Is it diet? Is it exercise? Is it a combination?
It definitely is a combination. So, I mean, exercise, we know that exercise is very good at helping us to get better sleep. If you exercise too late at night, it stimulates you. So then sleep becomes difficult. So exercise is good earlier in the day. You know, the type of foods that you eat, you want to start to eliminate some of that caffeine. Right. So caffeine in different types of foods. It's not just coffee. So different types of foods like chocolate. Okay. Try not to have caffeine late at night. Now all the sugary foods too.
Yeah.
And I know people like to have bedtime snacks.
Snacks, of course.
And if you're going to have a bedtime snack that's high in sugar, what happens is that your blood sugar levels go up while you sleep. Okay. And then they drop because it's a simple sugar. And when your blood levels drop, or blood sugar levels drop, your adrenaline surges, and that wakes you up. So you get that, you know, you wake up in the middle of the night, like, and you, a little bit of sweat, and you wake up in a startle, and then you have to quiet yourself to go back to sleep. That's your blood sugar levels dropping.
I see.
Yeah.
So then what else can you do? Are there alternatives, things to help you sleep better at night?
There are. So there are supplements that you can use to help you sleep. Melatonin, hands down, is probably the most popular and the most common supplement to help you sleep. You don't get that groggy morning after kind of feeling with melatonin like you can with some of the pharmaceutical sleeping aids. And it's a natural hormone that your body makes. It's a little gland in your brain, the pineal gland, that makes it. It makes less and less as we age, so that's when supplementation can come in. So melatonin you can get in a supplement form. This one is one that you dissolve underneath your tongue, which is quicker at getting into your blood system. And then you start to get into some other supplements that can complement melatonin. So other type of sleep aids that will have 5-HTP in it. And 5-HTP is like a serotonin precursor, and serotonin helps you to fall asleep quicker and stay asleep longer, and L-theanine, which also helps promote a deeper sleep. So there are some options on the market and different supplements that you can take to help sleep.
That's great. I think both of these. Can your body become dependent on them?
In essence, people would think that your body can become dependent. Melatonin, it doesn't, because what happens is melatonin is something you naturally make.
Right.
And as we age, the amount that we make decreases over time. So it's not something that you become dependent on. If you take melatonin and then you stop taking it, you're not going to get that rebound insomnia that you will get with a pharmaceutical sleep aid.
We know the importance of sleep. You throw stress into the mix. You know, how does this affect your overall health during cold and flu season?
Well, when you're not getting enough sleep and you're under a lot of stress, it weakens your immune system, and that makes you more susceptible to catching a cold or flu. So the incidence and the number of colds and flus you're going to get is going to increase.
As a doctor, what do you recommend? Because there are so many products out there on the market.
There are. So you have your ginseng-based, like cold effects.
Okay.
You have your echinacea-based, like cold attack. The benefits of an echinacea-based product is echinacea has been around for a very, very long time. It's very safe to take. So children can take echinacea. Children under the age of 6 just take half the adult dose.
Okay.
If you're pregnant, history has shown us that echinacea is safe for pregnancy. Always ask your family physician or tell your family physician what you're taking when you're pregnant.
Right.
But echinacea across the board is very safe to take without any drug interactions.
So what does echinacea do exactly?
Well, what echinacea can do for you during the cold and flu season, you can use it preventatively. So you can take it every day to prevent a cold or flu. But then you can take it at the first sign of a cold or flu. So it can either, you know, stop the cold in its tracks if you sort of get it at the right time and you're able to get in front or on top of the cold. Or if you already are developing a cold and you start to take it, what you'll notice is that the length of time that you have the cold will be less and the symptoms won't be as severe.
So what about vitamin C? Because when I think of colds, I think of taking vitamin C.
Yes, vitamin C for sure. We can't discount vitamin C. Vitamin C has been sort of the gold standard. It boosts our immune system. It's fantastic to take. There are a lot of different kinds out there. So just to give you a little information, ester C versus regular vitamin C. And the main question I get is, why would you take one over the other?
Right.
And regular vitamin C is called ascorbic acid. That's the scientific term for it. Okay. So it's acidic. If you're someone that has heartburn, acid reflux, taking regular vitamin C in high doses, you know, during the cold and flu season can make that heartburn or acidy feeling worse. Ester C is actually calcium ascorbate, so it's been buffered with calcium, so it's not acidic. So for people that have these conditions or people that are taking like acid reducing medication, ester C is for sure the way to go because it's easier on your stomach and you're not going to get any extra acid reflux.
That wraps up this segment. Thanks for joining us. I'm Deanne Ciccone for Viva News, and be sure to scan us next time.